Welcome back, everybody, here to the EIZO Cup, your 10th installment, and our grand final time, finally. And we've got all Russian on you. But we have VirtusPro going up against RoxKiss in our best of three grand final. And, well, I'm looking forward to a very, very, very entertaining matchup. If you're wondering why I got this huge grin on my face right now, I was having a chat to Cobb before we started talking about the negative armor strat. He's like, we never get it anymore. Like, we tried it a couple of times in scrims. Now, every team they play basically bans it out against them. That's why you see the ET being banned out here and the Alchemist also being taken away by Illidan. So the combination is gone out the window as far as what they were trying to do, but
10 seconds
at the same time, the flavor of the month is Bristleback. RoxKiss just completely curb-stomped the Q-Pat Red Pandas in their Starlight game. That's the reason why we had ourselves a bit of a delay before this game kicked off. But the delay is over, and we're all good to rock and rumble. Luckily, too, I have a man watching over my shoulder, so no mistakes like the last games. We have Nahaz, our stats man, joining me in the shoutcaster's box this evening. At least, not commentating-wise, he's just there as the stats man kind of thing. But he's always there. It's like I actually have someone to hold my hand this time around, where I sent Cap home before. That's it. For people ask, where's the capitalist? I sent him home to sleep. He has to be awake at 7 a.m. We must be awake at 7 a.m. tomorrow to cast G League. So if you have been tuning in for that coverage, by the way, I hope you have been enjoying it. We've been enjoying doing it, too. It's been some early starts, but it's been some really good games coming out from China. But it's good to also cast Russia versus Russia back to the Europeans, the roots. I say the roots, technically, I started out in the Southeast Asian scene. But yeah, this feels a little bit more like home of late. So Goblack, how are we starting up? Bristleback as well as Slark. So we get good offlaners, we get an insane mid laner as well if they want it from Slark, but also Slark of recent times being played as a hard carry role. So sitting up on that top lane, Goblack in fact took it himself recently, recently being last night. He was playing that Slark as the carry role. So we'll see if he wants to go down the same path again. But that was at the same time they put BZZ onto the Dazzle. But you see Illidan, like he takes out the Dazzle, he takes out the Elder Titan. He's taking away the combination-style heroes that work so well with Bristleback as well as Slark. Even first picking Abaddon to make sure that that was taken away from them. So Abaddon, Alchemist, and Crystal Maiden. It means that VirtusPro are going to be running Alchemist as a core in this scenario. I'm feeling the initiation, however, of VirtusPro is rather weak. There's no quick jump in. There's no ability to hold and control. Like the Crystal Maiden, like you got Crystal Maiden's Frostbite. Slark can easily get rid of that with Death Pack. There's no problem whatsoever. And then on top of that, now you've got like Abaddon, like he's going to give you a shield and get you out of there, but that's basically all you're really going to get from it. And then you look over towards like Goblack's lineup, and you've got Puck, good jump initiation. You've got Slark who moves very, very quickly and could also jump, pounce, and hold you there, and then do a large amount of damage while he does so and breaks off everything. Okay, Dark Pact. And then you've got Bristleback. Bristleback who's got Snot, so you've already got a slow against a hero like a Crystal Maiden. It's got very low movement speed. I'm liking RoxKiss's lineup a lot more with these first three pickups. And Illidan, like, I don't know how he can try and drag it back with this because he doesn't have support heroes to pick up anymore. He's already got the Alchemist, the Abaddon, and the Crystal Maiden. No matter how you look at that, two of these heroes will be a support. More than likely, Abaddon and Crystal Maiden. Carry Abaddon. Very few, if any, teams do that anymore. And even then, it was only done for, like, maybe two games. And that was it. And now I think it was done by BZZ for one of them, I remember. But Illidan now, he's got to be picking up core here. So he needs someone that's going to lane up against the Puck. Alchemist is someone he doesn't want to have that happen. Like, he doesn't want to throw the Alchemist in the middle lane. It'll be Puck in mid. It'll be Bristleback. More than likely, I'm going to have a gamble and say on the top lane as a solo. Maybe dual lanes again here from RoxKiss. The Lich as well as Dazzle are removed as well as the Abaddon. So they don't have, like, that extra... perfect pick. Absolutely perfect pick. Yeah, but they don't have like that extra security net. But with Rubick now in the mix, if they do dual lanes like I think they're going to do, which is the Bristleback up on the top lane, then the Rubick pulling through, so he gets a quick level 6 and also can toss back whoever's up on that top lane and harass him back out of the lane as well. Then you're going to have a quick level 6 on Rubick. He can still Shikuchi. You now have another level of initiation coming out from the RoxKiss lineup. Venomancer will be the last been out by Illidan. That would have been a good offlaner. But I'm not really feeling fully that the Venomancer would have been the pickup from Goblack. With a pickup from the Rubick, he might be looking for some rotating supports that could also like be a bit more of a nuisance. Venomance has it slow, but if you want to slow, then you could always just go with having the burst damage as well. Visage hasn't been selected yet. In fact, it's been completely ignored throughout this entire draft. And Roskis could even then go even more safer and then pick up something like a Chant or an Enchantress. So if it was an Enchantress, then you have the option to go aggressive jungle with your lineup. And if it's a Chem, then you can go safe, smoke up with the Rubick, try and gank up the middle lane as much as you possibly can, and just hope the Bristleback will survive in the bottom lane for the early portion of the game. That's the option right there. But VirtusPro have one last pickup. It's almost in this game, I wouldn't be surprised if we see something along the lines of like an Aegis Prophet for Light of Heaven.
10 seconds.
Something for his off lane. Because if he goes Mirana, he'll get stunned as he jumps out of the Dream Coil. Remaining. I suppose the same thing will happen to Prophet when he TPs out, but then he can get controlled and silenced up, and Sly can probably hunt him too. Okay, it's a real rough game for anybody that Light of Heaven wants to play. Unless the Timbersaw's been taken out. Was there something like Darkseer or Lone Druid? Would be the only other ones that come to mind that'd be left in the pool they could fight with. But Lone Druid will lose his bear very, very quickly to the Bristleback as well as his own life. And we get a Nyx Assassin coming up. So they're going to try and run Nyx in the middle lane up against the Puck, which puts Light of Heaven onto the Weaver. And that puts Illidan onto the Alchemist, would be the way I would read this draft from VirtusPro. And if that's the case, then Light of Heaven's going to be left to his own devices up in that top lane. Maybe they'd try and run the dual lane with the Abaddon. Problem is the Abaddon won't be able to keep up with the Weaver and give him the shields at the right time. But I suppose if Weaver's disabled Shikuchi back, then it's just up to Light of Heaven not to get caught out of position. But Nyx Assassin on that bottom lane. Crystal Maiden on the bottom lane with the Alchemist. That's a nice combination. A combination which could really harass and keep the Bristleback away. But also at the same time, if Bristleback starts stunning up the Crystal Maiden, it's very easy for Bristleback to get the first blood down there. So that's going to be the other thing to keep in mind. It's going to be very easy to feed with that Crystal Maiden. And this is a very mid-game orient. Like, yeah, the late-game potential for VirtusPro is actually quite good, but the problem is they'll never get there. And we go with Warlock. Well, you can always leave it to Gold Black to mix things up, and he's going to go for the Warlock, so we get the team fight potential, the Fatal Bonds, which will connect everybody together as well. This is going to be a really, really rough game for VirtusPro. And you also see who's playing it. Like, it's BZZ, but you'll see him play support. Seems like BZZ, this is now the second time in 2 days it's happened. I mentioned it during the drop before, where Gold Black was the man that took the Slark, but he's going to do this two times in a row now, where he puts BZZ onto this support kind of role. And BZZ will be heading down south. So it's going to be the Warlock combining up with the Bristleback. And I say that because he's coming down here with no ward. So he's not just coming down here to ward it up or something like that. He's here to actually be here. Well, back in base, we have Scandal. Mr. Orb Man is the Puck. Great solo mid player. He'll be there, and that puts Yol as the last supporter. And it's been a while since I've actually got to cast Yol's Rubick. He's a fantastic Rubick player, just because Rubick hasn't been played as much, and I haven't really got to cast much of Rox Kiss. I've been casting a lot of different things. A lot of different things. But yeah, it's great to have Yol in a game I'm casting, playing as Rubick. So that'll be the Crystal Maiden in this game with the lovely, lovely, lovely set. She looks beautiful. I still hate that showcase doesn't work here. Alchemist will be played by Illidan, so it looks like we're going to get our lanes exactly as predicted. Sergei will take God. God will be taking the next Assassin towards the solo mid, and then Light of Heaven as well has shot him up on the top lane. So, yeah, lanes are very, very predictable coming out from VirtusPro. There's no surprises whatsoever there. And we're off to a good start with the broadcast. Now all I have to do is just, like, miss the Aegis steal, and we're all good to and we're back on course with what we had previously during our last broadcast. Also, guys, if you want to stick around later on tonight, we will be having ourselves a little bit of fun. Well, I hope a little bit of fun. There will be a matchup between myself as well as a random user. I say also a random user. If you entered over on facebook.com/EIZO Cup, check your emails. I believe, I believe I'll be the one to be sent the winners. And I'll send some emails out at the conclusion of more than likely game number two. And then I'll host up the lobby when we're ready to rock and rumble. And then we play our 1v1 matchup in the middle lane, the winner of which will win a Forest FS2333 monitor. Okay, so we got wonderful pings. I don't think I'm pinging up that high. One way to check out. Nope, 39 ping. I'm great. All right, it's just all the Russians who are not having themselves a great time. But we'll have to have ourselves a bit of a rehost by the looks of it. Sorry. It's this new mic pack. Still haven't worked out why it's doing that yet. Now they're talking Russian, so we'll let them do their thing. Yeah, then we'll have ourselves a nice little playoff against each other. I don't know who it's going to be. It could be anybody. That could be great. It could be amazing. I don't actually even remember my record. My record has been rather sporadic. I remember I won the first two. And then I got schooled on the third. It was this weird matchup where it's like, you get to pick the hero you play up against me. It was this Batrider versus Batrider matchup, which I don't know if any of you have ever played like a 1v1 Batrider versus Batrider. I can tell you right now, it's crap. Like, it's absolute crap. It's napalm, firefly, and you both go in the opposite directions because you're going to burn each other to death with like two hits. So yeah, it's a fun way to go through the game. Yeah, but as you can see, there it is. It's up on the screen right now, what I'm talking about. We're having ourselves a rehost for the moment. So it shouldn't take long with the lobby hosted up. Payne is our admin for tonight. So he's taking care of all that kind of jazz to get us back inside the game. I also noticed the Twitch TV is having themselves some issues, at least in my region. That's Berlin. Because for some unknown reason, the video is it's opening up and then dropping for some known reason. We're fine. Everything going out is fine. And I got two computers which are running the stream previews. But for some reason, one of my computers is just not wanting to be cooperative with it all. So yeah, it's been tag teaming in and out. But I've reported it to Twitch. Hopefully they find a way and go, okay, something's wrong there. That's the hope, at least. That is the hope. All right, so Payne, rehost. I thought he was going to be really quick with this one. But it looks like he's going to be insanely slow. It's going to be very, very slow. All right, there we go. Now, oh yeah, there we go. Back in the lobby we go. We get to enjoy our Christmas theme. I hope you've all been playing Frostivus as well. I've been playing a couple of games. I don't think I've got really that far. Obviously, while we're here in the lobby, I can't actually show you how far I've gotten. But yeah, it's been a fun time. I'm just happy for once I get to be here. When the Christmas event is on. Because I don't know if you guys know last time. Like we're casting this event right now. G League is going to end on Thursday. Semifinals end on Thursday. And then there's a couple of days off for Christmas. And on Christmas Day, I'm flying to Singapore. I'm going to be casting the Asia or like the Asian Championship, which is going to be down there. I think it's actually the Asian Dota Championship, which is really kind of weird for me because the ADC was very, very old. That was like back in Warcraft 3 kind of time back in 2007, where the ADC was one of the most premier Dota tournaments out there for a grand prize total, get this, of I think it was $500 USD was the prize pool, and it was the most prestigious tournament in China at the time. Yeah. It's amazing how the scene has moved. It's really amazing how much the scene has moved over time. But I'm going to be traveling on Christmas Day to head down there. I'm going to be casting that event with gods. And then I actually have the first time in 2.5 years a holiday in Australia. 5 days only. And then we come back and we're going to do some really cool things. Really cool things in 2014. Like, we're winding down with the end of the year. Just a couple of matches here and there. Getting Cap used to his environment. And then we're going to absolutely, like, start slogging him out. As far coming up to next year. So definitely stay tuned for all that kind of stuff and some new stuff for joinDOTA, especially for the public. It's going to be over on joinDOTA, and you guys are going to love that. You should love that. You really should love that. All right, now the history lesson's over. We go all pick mode. Hopefully our server's going to be a little bit better this time around. I don't know if... Okay, no one's chatting, which means no one's saying things are horrible, which is normally a good thing. For a guy called Joseph Peter... No, you didn't have to be in this channel. You need to sign up over at facebook.com. It was up on the screen at the time. facebook.com/EIZO Cup. You can also like that page. You can follow all the other competitions. EIZO Cup is more than just Dota 2 now. It started as such, and then EIZO was like, yeah, this kind of cups are fun for people. Like, they love playing in the open cups. Give away some free stuff as well. So we ended up making one for Hearthstone as well as one for StarCraft 2. And on top of that, if you haven't done so yet, do so. There is one thing you still can enter, and that's for the free games. There's free copies of games. I believe the winner is being decided later on tonight, or the six winners are being decided later on tonight. But there's three copies of XCOM, Enemy Unknown, as well as Civilization 5. So we've got three games of each from 2K Games. So they're going to be giving those. We're going to be giving those away to people who have signed up. All you got to do is just answer that question over on EIZO Cup, over on joinDOTA.com. It's EIZO Cup game giveaway. Look for that title. I'm sure someone will link it inside the chat as well. So just, if you have a joinDOTA account, all you got to do is just cast your vote. It's very easy to know which one it's going to be. It starts with a K and ends with a P. Yeah. That's a trick answer as well. Yeah. You'll work it out when you see it. You'll work it out when you see it. All right. You can also check out iso-cup.com and they'll tell you all the details of who's won for how many different seasons. So there is no way you can screw up. So even if I am wrong, I'm pretty sure I'm right. I'm pretty sure I'm right. They've won basically everything we've done anyway. And then they went to China. Oh. Hmm. All right. So dual lanes, just to cap us back up again. So we'll have Yol as the Rubick. We'll have Slark being played by Goblack. Scandal in the middle lane, then the dual off lanes, BZZ supporting Warlock, and it'll be a DD Bristleback. He couldn't have asked for a better startup against Illidan. Illidan's going to get no CS during this first point of the game. And into the jungle, starts doing his little Crystal Maiden thing, two Clarities and Farm. It puts God in towards this middle lane as the Nyx Assassin, already Scandal putting out two Orbs to try and push him back again. And then Line of Heaven and Jotam up in this top lane as the Abaddon, as well as the Nyx Assassin, the Weaver. Yeah, the bug type. And, Illidan. BZZ. He's going to start with Harassment onto Illidan. Snot as well, or Seedoy. I don't know if you got... No. He doesn't have enough confidence to dive on that one, but look at the consumables that's there on the Alchemist. He can't survive this. He's got three stick charges, praying that all the Quill Spray was going to be enough to pick him off. But Seedoy hasn't even leveled it up yet. He went snot level one. He went full on aggression. He can just rely on his own hitting to bring down the creep waves.
We got this, Lane of Glody.
I love the Bristleback's voice. It's so good. Yeah. How's Goblack looking on this top lane? He now just got his third last hit, fourth last hit, 3-1, up against the Weaver, who's 5-0. It's going to be very hard to zone this lane out. Any kind of harassment damage just hit back straight away. Any kind of initiation, Jotam can just dispel it straight away. And if they don't do it on, if they do it on Jotam, then Line of Heaven just Shikuchi and starts harassing down the Rubick or Goblack directly. So it's really not a fun lane to be part of. And Goblack trying to get in close enough to hit on Line of Heaven, I wish him the best of luck. He won't be shifting any essence on that top lane. So it'll have to be a rotation at some point. But at the same time, Ronskis will also know their power here. They know that a farmed up Weaver is not going to hit his mark for a long, long time. Where Goblack, like, once he hits level 6, he won't care about what happens on this top lane. Even right now, Goblack has a very mediocre approach to this top lane. He doesn't need to be fully aggressive as long as he finds levels, and he finds it with Yol. Yol finds level 6, Shikuchi initiation. Like, it's just walking through the motions, just don't die, is the main goal right now. While this middle lane with Scandal and God, that's more of a lane of Scandal needs to ensure the kill on Sergei. Like, right now it's 12-5 up against 13-2. This is where the lane is possibly the most, like, competitive between the two players. And on this bottom lane, Illidan, he's also, like, on the same thing of, I must survive, which is the worst thing you can do up against a Bristleback, because Bristleback just needs a couple of levels, and then he'll just start to mow you. Very, very simple. Rubick up on this top lane. Light of Heaven being nice and aggressive with Shikuchi. He knows how far he can run up with that thing and get back down again before he can be telekinesis and then attacked by Slark. And Yol would probably do that anyway. He's got a lot of burst damage up his sleeve because he has a second point up in the Fade Bolt. That's why I'm trying to keep my eyes a little bit closer right now on Light of Heaven. We've only got now, okay, that's third point up in Goblack. His Dark Pact is not really that much damage, like it's only 75 damage. But he's still going to level up anyway. It's not as though like he's going to shake anything off on this top lane, which means he's looking to dish out damage. That's what that's for. There's no ability he'll get rid of. Scandal, has he got a stun? Oh, we do. You can see he's trying to bait it out. There's your stun. Scandal, this will be first blood. Mana burn as well as a right click. Nice little play there from God. He attacked, then followed the mana burn, and then followed directly up with the attack. It was the most efficient way of using his animation timing. And that gives him the first blood up against the puck. And it's a big kill as well. Whoops, Sunda jumped off that lane. Light of Heaven being latched in there. And that's that dark back going to work. But as I said before, they're not going to get a kill with this. It's more just being overly aggressive on this top lane. I got a funny feeling Goblake tried to do that so he can bump up his gold so he can get closer towards having a ring. I like this rotation. BZZ. He was the man that was moving in through mid. But with the Invis rune, he's got himself upheaval, so he wants to slow down the Abaddon. Goblack needs more life points before he can fight this. So now, well, he starts off with the... Okay, that shield, it doesn't actually break the Shadow Word, but it does tick it out. So Jotam, that Shadow Word's only... it's a level 2, but it's not enough damage to get the kill.
Much obliged.
And then he gets the heal from BZZ. And what do we got for Yol? Yol's having to move back to base to heal up. Nyx's Assassin's already on the hunt. He's going to find BZZ. Yeah, he might have enough damage for this. With the mana burn, yeah, he's got this. One more attack, there it goes again. So again, just a simple attack, just Vendetta attack in. Follow up with a stun. Hit him once, mana burn, hit him again. And that means also now that Sergei's got a bottle up and running. Slow life at Jotam, but he's able to walk back to base quite safely. While Light of Heaven's harassing Goldblack back off this top lane. Scandal might think about this middle lane jumping in again. He's managed to get back on the CS, but it's because Sergei's rotated twice, but at the same time, he's got two of these kills. With the Spike Carapace trying to return the damage to Scandal, but Scandal, he also knows the problem of that Spike Carapace from the next Assassin, so just phase shifts out when the damage could possibly be coming his way. It's a problem when Radiant's you go for such obvious orbs. Under attack. You basically have to use your phase shift to evade that reflection damage. Goblack, this is something nice of him at least. Having Warlock just give him that heal before he left. Still have extra life points, but interesting to see the Warlock. Like, normally you'd see a lot of Fetter Bonds level ups. Light of Heaven, are they going to pick him up? He's in range of the tower. They do drag him back, but there's the heal as well as the shield. Just trying to break off a lot, so Light of Heaven can then dive on Goblack, who committed a lot of life points to stay in that close. He really needs his level 6. Once the level 6 is up, he won't care about anything else. Bottom lane, Illidan's under attack. Scandal's bound down here to try and attack him. With the Illusion Rune, he should just dive this in. He's got an orb up in 1 second time. Oh no, they've got the Salisbury popping up from Illidan. And Sergei's TP'd in. Phase shift, Scandal, orb. You have to jaunt to the other side of the tree line to get as far away from that Nyx Assassin as possible. But Nyx using a TP score to rotate down for that one. Where it was just Puck grabbing Illusion Rune, trying to make an opening. And he's going to move up right underneath the Observer and Sentry Ward. And now going to attack, jump back down again. It's his own Sentry Ward that he was using to get rid of that Obs. I'd say he'd want to know if he was visible at the time. Which he wasn't. PZZ, life be hard. Now we finally get the Fatal Bonds up and running. During the team fight, that's going to be the worst thing. Because you just consider the team fight. So you're going to have... a Bristleback. Cool spraying up everybody. Now that's damage to everybody. Who is then Fatal Bonds, possibly upheavaled, so they're slowed down as well. And then you get the Chaotic Offering also dropping from the sky. So you got an AoE stun, Goblike jumping in there with the Dark Pact, which is also another area of effect ability. And then you got Puck with a Dream Call, which will hold him there even longer, which can give the time for Warlock to do his Fatal Bonds, to give his Shadow Word over, to then cast the ultimate, to then also use the upheaval. So the first thing is your controller up from Scandal, and then the second thing is the controller from the Warlock. And then you got Rubick on top of that. Mr. Telekinesis grab one hero, AoE stun as they drop down, steal abilities, Fade Bolt takes away all the damage, and also another area of effect, well not an area of effect, it's a bouncing attack, the Fade Bolt. One that's kind of throwaway kind of things, but I kind of like the damage, 210, but the damage reduction of 26 to every single hero, that's a lot. Bottom lane, Illidan's in trouble. Bristleback able to get that kill on the Alchemist, and now finally Ross just get themselves on the board. Scandal going into his boots.
Radiant's bottom tower Treads. Is under attack.
BZZ is trying to find his level 6 in the middle lane, while on the top lane, Nyx Assassin's rotating out there. Goblack, he does have his level 6, but he's quite visible right now, and the Nyx Assassin initiated further back. And y'all, he'll go down again, Sergei. Another great rotation, another great gank, and another successful kill. That's 3 for 3, or actually, technically, it's 3 for 4. because he did rotate down towards that bottom lane with the TP scroll. And didn't get a kill from that. Bottom lane, we're going again. Snot's up. Scandal already hit him with the AWP. Illidan, he's got the Chemical Rage up and running right now. Turns to attack on top of Seedoy. But with three levels of Snot now, four levels of Snot. Just keep spraying it down. One more spray and he's got him. Fifth Snot, and now another spray. Sergei's going to get the stun and he gets a revenge kill. That's now 4-0 over on God. 4 out of 5 of the rotation successful. There was some action up on top lane. Saw Goldblack coming up the river, trying to attack from the side. At least I assume that was Goldblack. He still wants to try and bring down Jotam. He doesn't have level 6 yet. So the shield will come. Darkpack got to go. Light of Heaven will take the damage from that too, but Jotam does the wisest thing he possibly can. Maybe just TP's himself back out again. Goldblack's still got 13 wand charge. He'll have to use it before Shikuchi. Use him! He's got pounce in 1 second time, but he's got to back up. He didn't want to use it because he knows he's going to regenerate up pretty quickly once he just hides from vision. But when Line of Heaven Shikuchi's like that, there is no other choice for Goldblack. He has to stay out of vision. He's trying to stay within experience range. But 27.6 HP regen per second is a very nice thing for a Slark to have. If people also didn't realize, because I just saw someone just talk about stuff. Potato Editor is having some time in the chat. I don't know what he's talking about. But I didn't notice the words in-game. If you guys don't know, you can actually check out these games all inside the client. You'll have to find the game. It's your only downside. There was no ticket for it. Oh, goodbye, Slark. That's now 5 out of 6 conversion rate. Well, bottom lane, we're going to go again. Illidan straight into the Chemical Rage. He actually did a really nice thing then, too. He used its ulti to evade the first Snot Ball. Chaotic Offering went down too, but didn't really get the proper control over Illidan. And now he's prepping the stun. They're all very much grouped up together. So all four heroes, there's not even three, especially only the two heroes and the big Warlock, or the Warlock Golem, getting stunned up there. And Jotam now starts attacking on top of Scandal. Rotation's coming in from the next. Actually, it's not Asart. That's his color. And TP out by Warlock. Frostbite's going to stop him. BZZ. That's not the way he wanted to throw his ulti out for the first time. Sergei looking for the stun. Scandal going to phase shift. Also in a better position. God had to go up there to check anyway. The attack will stun Scandal. Yeah, but Dota TV, it is active for all these games. You just got to find it inside the client. There is no ticket for it. Gotcha. Oh, Illidan. He'll be fine. In fact, he turns on the stun right now to Goldblack. And Goldblack trying to dark pack down this one. He's got his ulti up as well. 10 wand charges available. And with Seedoy coming in, sussing up on Sergei. They want his life. He is worth so much money right now if Seedoy can kill him off. But they're trying to find him. He's gone Vendetta. He's searching for Yol. What do we got stolen? It's the missed call for Yol. He might be able to deny himself. No, he can't. The Alchemist just loops in the concoction. Seedoy in too deep. He's got 8 stick charges. Not one charge. They're only stick charges in this game. But with the stun over an Arsart, Orb jump down. Bristleback's able to get that kill. Moving over to Illidan. He's blocked in. He's blocked in by the creep wave. He's got himself another stun, but Goldblack's now come to join the fight. Seedoy will tank up the first part with the upheaval. It really slowed down the Alchemist. Now he's going to cancel that one off BZZ. He's got Fatal Bonds, which should be cast off as well. Being stunned up, being follow stunned up. It's a double stun, and now just the Weaver. Double kill for Line of Heaven, running through the corpses of Roxkiss up towards Scandal. The attacks do start. One charges. He can orb and phase shift. So there goes the phase shift. Orb away to the other side of the river, and he's locked inside the tree line. Line of Heaven's on the Shikuchi run up. He's caught. He didn't think he was in the tree line. Sergei's getting himself out of here. Scandal can't get out. He's got 4 wand charges. That's not enough. Yol's running himself down with Shikuchi. You got to pick up on Sergei. This is the kill they wanted. Double stun, but Slark ends it. 674 gold goes the way of Goldblack. The Blink Dagger will be purchased up with the Nyx Assassin because there was just so many kills that went his way. That was a 5 kill streak that was just ended by the Slark with the help of the Rubik Shikuchiing in. Using Weaver's ability to initiate in on the Nyx Assassin. Catching him in the corner. Finally, Scandal has managed to get himself back to base. Radiant, but Seedoy is going to tank up this tower. Attack. You can see with the amount of magical damage he knows he's going to be taking during this fight, during this game. He had to pick up that casual cloak. He doesn't have to complete it into a hood or anything like that. He might consider doing so, though. But this is enough for Seedoy. I don't know if we see a Rod of Atos as well coming out from him. Bottom tower is under attack. But right now, Bristleback with his magic resistance, the Vanguard Radiant's regeneration, and also the block from the Vanguard's quite high. On top of that, he's only got 2 points up in the Bristleback, but it's going to It's going to rise quickly. That Bristleback's already becoming a huge problem. And Weaver, the man who ran hand of Midas, building it towards Lincoln Sphere. The timing's not looking too bad for it. They see him? There's no sentries. There's definitely no gem. Yeah, they didn't see him. There's just some pings coming out. Nick's kind of like moved as though he was being watched. Scandal. Feeling that stun was just a little bit longer than what it really was. But we've got ourselves a 4-1 split right now. Four players from either team in the middle lane, so Scandal's going to do his TP out towards top lane, because that's where Light of Heaven is. He's the one that split off from VirtusPro. Well, down the bottom lane, Bristleback's just down here, tanking up the Great Wave and pushing it out towards the Tier 2 tower down there. RoX do, of course, still have that tower advantage. And overall, even that tower advantage doesn't really show. It just dragged back the gold a little bit. Gold Black's on the run up towards the top lane, but Sergei's going to find him. Light of Heaven, Shikuchi's away. But you'll notice Gold Black, like, now he doesn't have his regeneration. That's instantly going to flag a warning bell, but obviously not fast enough. Nice silence by Scandal. I don't know if he even saw that one coming, but he's phase shift into the corner. No bugs on him, so he'll survive this one. And Gold Black, he's locked Sergei in position. They need more damage. They don't have it. Sergei gets himself away. TP's out almost instantly. And what a silence from Puck. Unbelievable he was able to get that silence off. He wouldn't even seen him before, like, with the Vendetta hit. Like, it's like he silenced before the Vendetta even connected. I'm not trusting my eyes today, though. Light of Heaven, running right in the middle of the team. He doesn't have his bugs anymore. No, he does. He's got his Crypt Swarm. He can throw it right over the team. In fact, there it goes. They're going to split themselves up. First stun over on Seedoy. Lost a lot of his armor already. Light of Heaven being picked up, and now the Chaotic Offering's going to drop. Nuking down the overcommitting Weaver. And with this big Warlock Golem with a creep wave coming in too, they will beat down this Tier 1 tower, and it is forfeit. Over on the side, looks like God doesn't want to. He's going to align, he's going to mana burn up Yol to start with. So he knows he's in the corner, but blinks away. Yeah, Bristleback will take the tower. Rubik sealing abilities. What do we got? Acid Spray level 4. Just trigger that, and you can easily cover the retreat. But it's 9-6 on the board. RoX take now their second tower. And they're moving further and further ahead in the net worth. Weaver's still looking very, very good. Even with his death, that's his first death to his name. Radiance middle, it's going to be even sadder Light of Heaven that he was dying while his hand of Myas was off cooldown. Yeah, he uses it instantly. He gets to the lane. Surprisingly, though, he uses it on the range unit. Small little thing, but it's just a little bit more economical to use it on the melees. They're not worth as much money as the range unit, BZZ. Oh, ho, 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 ho. He's dead. So dead. With the Blink Dagger on Sergei, he's going to TP out, hit Yol. Needs telekinesis. God, cancel his TP. Realized he didn't have time. So he's going to bottle up, move to the side. Running back in front of a creek wave, which won't spawn up because his timing's quite right for this. Weaver. Okay. A DD rune over on the Puck being activated. Gets the kill on the Weaver. Light of Heaven's away from all kind of support, so just assume silence. And what was going to be a nicely timed Lincoln Sphere now becomes a really badly timed Lincoln Sphere. It's going to be way too late for him. Rumor coming back in towards the mid lane again. Sergei going for yet again another attempt to kill off somebody. He found Yol. The ping's coming. I think Yol spotted him for a moment. That tower vision would have been close enough, so they throw down the sentry ward, pick up telekinesis. Pick him up, throw him down. Sergei, he's still got the ability to attack with the Vendetta, but he's now being locked in position. BZZ, all of a sudden, it goes towards the two supporters. Sergei still trying to get himself away. Heal from Jotam. They can give him the shield as well. Goblin jumping in deeper. They wanted him, and they got him. You should have hid when you saw Sergei onto the sidelines. Arcane Boots, Blink Dagger is what he will stay at, and hasn't really changed his items for a while now. But still, that's still damn good items, because he had such a fantastic start. The first blood in the Puck, the rotation up towards top. Both of those being a success, you couldn't have asked for a better start for him. But now just a bit of a hiccup coming into the later portion of the early game. Scandal's going to jump in towards the mid lane. Dream Call in 5. Unless he can catch somebody else out. Arsart's the one he can. He's trying to farm up for the moment. Scandal going to rotate in towards the middle. He's out of sight though. So it's going to be a movement up towards the top lane instead. Line of Heaven still farming up here. He's got enough to pick up at least, or at least finish his Perseverance. And with this much money, he'd prefer to go for the ultimate orb. with a Dream Call. I'm wondering, oh, he's right underneath the Sentry Ward too. Dream Call will be used, Light of Heaven, Orb damage. He's able to time-lapse him. He takes the stun damage from that too. Then goes Invis, still visible. Scandal, Blink Dagger, he's still on cooldown. And use it to initiate in instead. I think it was a rather hopeful endeavor there from Scandal to do that. He needed more support. There was no way he had the damage just to kill off Weaver in that scenario. With Strength Trust Wars, Ring of Aquila. Just a little bit too much armor and life points to get through for just one puck. Maybe if Scandal got his Dagon like he did in the last game, then it will be a chance. As a spray level 4 still over on that Rubik. Necro units as well coming out for the Alchemist. I suppose with the Grievel's Greed, he's got potential to really finish that one off, but Illidan, he's sacrificing himself in order to do this. But you can kind of understand the reason why, especially now we see Goldblack. Goldblack's done this build over and over again, and I'm pretty sure Illidan's going to be very much aware of it. He did it last night, and he's doing it today. Where you go with this, they've got sentries. They saw him run through there. There was observers and sentries. They know that Sergei's going to be around here, but Sergei doesn't know that Roshan's happening. He's going to walk in there. He sees Sido walk out now. But no one's going to initiate apart from top lane where Puck and Goldblack. There's that support you're searching for. And surprise, Shadowblade, sentry. They need a sentry ward down here. Have they even got another one? No, they don't. There's your initiation and already dead. Nyx Assassin gets the kill. I think Jotun was coming in there to lend an extra bit of damage. But Alchemist preparing the stun. Chaotic Offering, BZZ, Fatal Bond's not going. But he's not even using it. He's got level 2, but he goes for Upheaval instead. Slowing down Illidan, so now Goldblack can jump in. And he's going to leech up on Illidan, and Illidan's dead instantly. Jotun to be following up. That Golem does a lot of damage, and the Dream Call. It's caught too. Arsar trying to come and help. Jotun's ulti's already been triggered off, but he'll go down as well. Nyx with the stun's not going to help. He does have Vendetta, and he might try and get a pick off here. And they go back in for Roshan now, with four players from VP going onto the sidelines. No one buying back after it. And there goes Roshan. Negative 5 on the armor. There's that orb. Again, that's the Orb of Venom over on Goldblack.
Roshan has fallen to the
1500 dark. Gold going his way too. So Shadowblade initiation to come from him. Allows him to really move in hard and attack hard too. That initial hit onto the Crystal Man is going to remove most of Arsart's life points. And he tried to go for a little bit more of a greedy kind of style build. So going with the Hand of Midas. He's just trying to find those fast levels as well as items. It means he's going to rely a lot more on Jotun to keep him alive during these engagements, though. Because you see him with 739 life points. That's hardly anything. He is walking around, too. I don't know if he knows he switched himself to agility treads. Quite possible while he's just farming up that it's worthwhile doing so. But also having the intel when you cast the abilities. I got a funny feeling he's just tapped the button, hasn't realized.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Line of Heaven on this top lane. Now there he goes. He's back to strength treads. Hey, chat trivia. Been a while since I've done one of these. Name the only 3 Euros to build Blink Dagger more than 100 times in 6.79 Pro Dota 2 matches. The instant one is Puck. There's no doubt about it whatsoever. There's going to be Puck. I'm actually wondering if all 3 are right here inside this game. Rubik wouldn't have been picked up enough for it, so it can't be Rubik. Like in the older patch, it would definitely be Rubik. It was every single time. Scandal can initiate. While the mid lane's also being initiated, we'll stick with Illidan here on the bottom lane. Goldblack already got the kill back towards middle lane. Yol telling it to pick up and drop down very quick because of the shield. But Yol, with the word, it's not enough to keep him alive. Abaddon came up for the... Well, she wasn't even a nuke. It was just the shield that triggered. But it becomes a 1-1 trade. Support's going down either way. Yeah, but Puck's going to be my first one. I'm wondering if Earthshaker has played in 100 games and had enough farm in 100 games to get a Blink Dagger. I doubt it. I'm interested to see what the chat's going to say. I'm actually going to bring my Heroes page up over on my side so I can also just have a bit of a gander. Magnus? I wasn't really played enough. S4 played him a hell of a lot, but not enough other teams really did, so... So I wouldn't put Magnus into that lineup. But yeah, I'm still feeling it's going to be Puck. Nick's Assassin was going to be the other one I was thinking about too. Has been played a hell of a lot too. Like he's kind of making the same basket as the Rubik for that one. For who would have actually picked up the Blink Dagger. There's a couple of Tinkers here and there which were always going Blink Daggers, but I don't think, again, like it's over 100 matches being played. And that's where the catch comes in. Like, you need to have over 100 matches on a hero. Well, Scandal, Trouble, Phase Shift, trying to evade the stun. He did so. Sergio was just a little bit too early on the stun. I think he had a feeling that Scandal was going to jump himself back out of that very, very quickly. Get all excited about that gem dropping to the deck. Because there is that gem over on Puck now. So Scandal has the extra vision. Yeah, de-warded out too. Missing uphill. Ooh, Phase Shifts out the first stun. And then blinks him. Dream Call. They want him. Sergey, he's got Vendetta. Gonna try and TP himself away, but Yol with a pickup throw down. There's five players here from RoxKiss to ensure the kill on the next assassin. Puck is the man to get the kill. Puck, Batrider, and Earthshaker. Oh, I got two of them. I don't know why, but I wasn't really feeling the Batrider. I don't know. I surely should have as well. My bad. But Puck and Earthshaker. Two out of three. Not bad. Even though I was saying Nyx Assassin as well as Rubik at this one. Yeah, I didn't think Earthshaker hit 100, so I technically only got one. I can't steal points in this. I only got one. Puck was the bloody obvious one. Middle tower has fallen. And I'm watching the chat right now to see if anyone else got that. Puck, Magnus, and Batrider. I heard that one out from Yoshi. I give him points. Yeah, there's some guy in the chat's like, yeah, I forgot about Batrider too. We all forgot about Batrider. After his nerf, everyone Dyer's forgot about Batrider. Is under attack. Dyer's structures are fortified. Now bottom lane push. Dyer's top lane will be pushed out as well. Light of Heaven with that Des. Ooh, I like that from him. I really, really like that from him. Radiant's bottom tower. He knows he needs his DPS attack. Already. We've got that Halberd build coming the way of the Bristleback. In fact, with the amount of money he's got, it almost looks like Bristleback is going to skip over the Halberd and just go straight into the Assault Cuirass. Lincoln's Fear is on the way for Goldblack too. So no BKB for him. In fact, he just wants to have the Lincoln's. Radiant's bottom tower, goes down. There's your Blink Dagger up on Rubik. Add that to his count. Dyer's and the Necro Book level 2. Necro Book level 1. Mass Necro books coming up from VP. Who needs a gem when you have level 3 Necro units on the field? Dyer's middle tower is under attack. Our starts doing the same thing. And we go Radiance. 26 minutes in, and Cedo is now going to pick up a Radiance. He's flying the entire thing out to himself at the moment. Alchemist getting ganked up by three players on top of the Ancient area. All right. Aegis Immortal is also about to be reclaimed. I'll go back to the Bristleback. At least he'll have his full mana back up and running again. I don't know if he knows the timing exactly, but this Radiance burn. This is Crystal Maiden, Nyx Assassin, Weaver, all having massive issues. Same with the Abaddon. Alchemist is probably the only person who doesn't really care about it too much. And there's your Radiance burn. Push out creep waves, and you've got this continuous burn. You see, he's taking damage and the regeneration doesn't stop. That's the power of the Aegis Immortal regen. So you're also the reason why it just says, like, tooltip when you hover over it. Thanks to Haas as well for giving me props on my camera work. I fucked up a lot today. Oh, they smoked! Right on top of Goblack! They weren't expecting him to be there, but look at Light of Heaven! That damage to the Chaotic Offering is going to buy the space for Goblack! No, the Alchemist! He ends the Unstoppable Streak and then also grabs the Warlock. 826 worth of gold. In fact, over that, he hits about 1,300 bonus gold. That's level 3 Necro books right there with a kill. But Yol wants the sweet-ass revenge, and with that, they've got it. Alchemist lost a lot of life points very quickly, but he's got his level 3 Necro books. Light of Heaven's coming up. He wants Yol. He's the easiest hero to kill off. They might require the blinking from Sergey. Yol goes over towards the side. He didn't realize how close he is to Sergey, but then Scandal goes for the Dream Call. The orb up is right on top of the Nyx Assassin. Spy cameras, he missed the stun. Yol basically ran circles around him. He went for a do-si-do. Now, finally, We will be seeing the Rubik take a fall. 3 euros in the sidelines, but Bristleback, he's still Radiance burning down everyone that's here. This is also we're going to include the Necro unit. So Sito's going to find himself getting some extra bonus gold without really intending it, and maybe taking some damage. Spire Carapace, again, a quick stun on him. The Golem will go down a little bit deeper in Arsart. Scandal battling it out. Radiance jumps back up, or will he? He dies. The gem's on the deck. Nothing. That's going to be picked up quickly as well. Arsart, go over there and grab it. Well, his Necro units can't hold these. Oh, TP scrolls on the ground. Okay. Attack. So Sergei will take it. And we go 17-16. Top tower is under attack. Dire's bottom kind of feels tower very, very similar to a game we had in our semi-final. Yes, that was VP going up against Mousesports. So much killing, so many commitments as well, almost to a point of over-commitments. I'm not surprised it's only the seventh Radiance ever completed on a Bristleback, because like Bristleback with the recent Bristleback trend, we've been looking at him go high points up. Like we go Evasion, we go Assault Cuirass, we go Heaven's Halberd, we go Heart. We look at these kind of builds on the Bristleback. But the old classic, like if you had stats from Bristleback back in 2007, 2008, you were always looking at the Radiance. This guy ruled the waters as far as burn. No one would go anywhere near him just out of the pure fear of death by burn. That was the fear. It's like eating a dinner course in Asia for me. The fear of death by burn. Some rough nights. I have a very simple metabolism. D warning now with the Necro level 3 units. Roxx is going blind on the map. They really need to stop this. I don't know how though. The only other option is to completely push it out, but Sido needs time to farm up. So he's moving up towards the top. He knows there's like a creep wave and a half up here. Even if Sergei finds him, like Sergei's now started to burn already. He doesn't want to be part of that. Roshan, okay, that's one way to do it. Just push it out. Warlock's starting to build in towards his Aghanim Scepter. Scanner with Blink Dagger. He's got his... Oh, he's short. Oh, is he? No, I think he's got enough for the side device. Yeah, he does. He's got... Yeah, do the math. 100 gold. And the Lincoln Sphere comes up from Goblack. So key item time for Roskis. Two tier 3 items now get completed. And they'll look to attack more. God runs away. Goblack with that Shadow Blade. He triggered almost instantly. Look at that movement speed. Just remember, he's still staying invis right now. Jumps up. He was looking for the leash. Goblack starts the Dark Pact, which means no stun's going to affect him. Triggers the ult, and Ghost Scepter makes it a little bit more difficult, but Dark Pact again. Going to come off cooldown. Had to wait a little bit longer, but leaps over and the water goes everywhere. And that's a big kill. That's the reason why Goblack committed to that. The gem was over on the Nyx Assassin. So the gem is now back into the hands of Roxkiss. I don't know if they bought another one up quickly. No, they didn't. And VP, well, they have managed to drive back a lot of that gold. That's also because they started bringing down some towers, farming up the enemy jungle. But more importantly than anything else, it was the fact that these two hands of mice have been really working their asses off. Alchemist using his Necro units to kill off towers. Because it's never really a great thing. Like, when Goblack picks off the Necro unit, okay, Sidoi is going to be the man to take the damage. Like, even Goblack or Sidoi, they've both got really good regeneration. Sidoi not as great as normal Alchemist has, Bristleback has. Goblack, he's just got to get invis from the enemy and he just has this huge regeneration. And we're going to go on Roshan now. They need that snot though. Alchemist needs to get in there. Oh, I mean, what am I talking about? Alchemist's already in there, but they need to get the levels of snot up. With all five heroes, Roshan negative two. He's even being done by the Sanjay. He's been having a lesser maim on him. And there goes Roshan. Looks like BZZ, judging by his jumping. Gold got the last hit there. He's going to enjoy that. Brings him now even closer. What do you get? You got the Ogre Club. So life points for now. Gold Black killing for now. Abaddon, he can leash him in here. Even if he just triggers the ulti right now, I don't think that's really going to be enough for Gold Black. He wants this pure kill. Lincoln Spear will go off. And now he has to trigger the ulti. His own ulti to run away. That's why killing off Abaddon is like, it's just so damn difficult. 497 move speed. Damn, he moves fast. That's almost a haste rune. Almost. Not quite, but almost. To the guy, Rage Platypus, I fear the Asian cuisine is what I fear. Dash by Shnushnu. I'm happy to take that, Lockheed. I'm most definitely happy to take Dash by Shnushnu. I'm in Singapore and Australia in 2 weeks. Who knows? I may never return. Ah, good times. Great music. Death by Shnushnu.
Dire's structures are fortified.
Chasing Goblack.
Dire's
God, look at that leap away. But five, it is a haste room for Goblack. That movement speed. He turns. Stun's gone. Goblack will go this. Spike Carapace. The leash. He needs more damage. Needs more damage. Oh! With the Dark Pact. If he started with that one as well. It was close. It was close. We'll leave it at that. It was close. But you see the killing potential. He's got 10 essence shift points. Like, he attacks so quickly. But to have a bonus 30 agility just from this essence shift. Makes Slark one powerful machine. While Bristleback also looking at him. He's a recipe away from having the Assault Cuirass. So not only do we have like an armor aura, we then have the Radiance Burn aura. We have him with a large amount of life points and a possibility to give out a lesser maim. And then the double block. This is why Bristleback really, he must be in the first two bans. But both teams, okay, maybe this is the reason why we see more and more Bristleback. Because you look at him and go, well, we can deal with him if we get enough. Ooh. 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 So, okay. He's got no Spike Carapace. He's got no stun. He's got Vendetta. Goes Invis. Runs away. Bottom lane, Illidan's waiting to initiate. Yeah, there is. No. Illidan! It was almost next level summoning. It was almost next level summoning. Oh, wait, give us some eyes. There we go. Oh, I love it. Leash down. Goblack tried to chase up the Light of Heaven. The Light of Heaven with Shikuchi just a little bit too fast. It's a holiday summoning. No work this time around. It's merely a casual social event. Light of Heaven battling up against BZZ. He doesn't want to have to drop his ulti down for this one, but they've got to get that bug off him. And no. Damn, that's a lot of damage with the Desolator effect flying. Illidan's already prepping a stun. Seedoy, the man who's visible. Illidan, he stuns himself. Now Goblack jumps on him. The Snot goes. They're trying to focus on Illidan, but the Quill Spray, a Radiance Burn as well, not helping him out. Nyx Assassin's going to burn to death in this fight. He's on it towards the high ground. Goblack, Lingus Field will trigger. God finally goes down. One was stolen. It was the Phonic Shield. You couldn't have asked something better. Now he can save Jotun. There's a shield. A lot of damage over towards, well, actually, it came back the way of the man, Jotun. No ulti available. Line of Heaven. Snotted up, but Shikuchi's still there. So slow has no effect, but Goblack looking to leap and pounce onto Arsat. He goes on Line of Heaven. BKB from Line of Heaven has a trigger. Goblack throws his ulti off so he can break free as well. He needs more space. Scandal trying to get the bug off him, but he just couldn't work fast enough. Now Bristleback doesn't finish the AC. In fact, he buys a BKB at this point. Seedoy, this is one confused man. Alright, so Seedo back into his jungle. I really hope he does finish up this Halbert, finally. Like, he do have the BKBs up and running. But up against heroes like an Alchemist who hasn't finished his yet. Or is that on the Courier? Yeah, it's on the Courier. Actually, no, it's Daedalus. That's a full Daedalus, too. That's the Weavers. Damn Light of Heaven is really scary in this game. He is really scary, his damage output. They have got to nail him down. They need the Scythe of Ice. They've got it, but they need to have it on Light of Heaven every single time. Scandal needs to initiate on him. He's coming up towards the top lane to keep that creep wave off the tower. 4k gold also on Scandal. Wondering what he wants to bring to the fight next. Does he look for a little bit of stability himself? Yay! Seedoy! He stopped having an item identity crisis. Woo! Now he's just going to finish up the AC and he's all good. And he can sell Vanguard and pick up a heart. Yes. Wait, have we got... No. Creep just turned around. They're coming back. But they put the Euphotic Shield up on the Necrobooks. Jump away from Goblack. Once he's able to escape out, the stun again. I don't even know if Mana Burn was used to try and trigger the Lincoln Sphere first. As a Shiva's Guard. I was wondering if it was going to be that stability for Scandal. Because there was no other really big item they needed. Like, these team fights are happening. So, no! Whoa! Okay, hold the phone, hold the fights. Ross Kiss, take 3 minutes out of your schedule and don't attack anybody. They just lost the Shivas. There was the full Shivas on the courier as well. The Necro units were just farming out the jungle casually. And on the transfer up, the courier saw him, but the reaction was there fast enough that they got the courier killed, VP, before it delivered its item. I don't know if they were fast enough to actually see what units they actually really denied to Rock's Kiss there. Either way, that's going to be a big concern right now to Rock's Kiss. And that bought the time for Alchemist to finish up his BKB. Scandal looks like he's still not having any kind of... We're doing some dewarding with the gem. If all else fails, just start going for ward again. Look at the ward positioning too. The Necro units won't be able to see up there to deward that out. And even some of these other positions are rather, I won't say unusual. But the amount of Necro units coming up from VirtusPro is going to be almost like they're going four level three Necro books. The Necro army is even stronger. The Fatal Bond's going to end up killing BZZ off by it. Like, does that even attack him then? Because technically they kill each other off. I know the summon units don't affect him. But if something in Necro, if it gets attacked by like, I suppose it'll be... Like if you dish out the damage, it's then like transfer it over the Necro units to the guy who did the initial attack. So even without killing off a Necro unit, you can take the damage. I don't know the mechanics of that. I don't know the mechanics of that. The basic question. If you kill off a unit because of Fatal Bonds, do you take the damage? Because I know the illusions don't take the damage anymore, but I don't know if that was changed around. But my mechanic question for the chat, something to practice and check out. It's been a while since we've seen Warlock played, so not many people would have really gone through that. Upheaval, just trying to buy the space so Cito can beat down this tower. Dish is over 250 damage per hit when he does that kind of jazz. Are they really looking to try and breach? They're going to try and get these top two heroes to TP back. Sergei as well as Light of Heaven. Yeah, here they come. Up towards the high ground. Leap away. They're not looking to initiate here. You got two levels up in the Chaotic Offering. That's not too bad. But fighting up against an army of Necro books, as well as VP, all they want to do is just make him fall back. So I wouldn't be surprised if we see TP's top. Yeah, look at Cito just damaging himself down. Radiant Spurn doesn't help him either. He almost needs his heart before he finishes up the AC right now. Just out of pure fear of taking that damage. BZZ has to keep that Shadow Word working overtime on Cidoy. And there's your TP back flying to top lane. Goldblast's going to clear this up. He's going to go into a Basher for his build. His primary goal, Light of Heaven still. Light of Heaven has to be the goal. The Abyssal Blade to kill him off. Roshan, the big man's up. And this movement with Acid Spray, with the amount of damage coming out from the Weaver, they can just smoke and go in. Y'all's trying to push out this bottom lane, but he's got Blink Dagger, and he's also trying to build into a Scythe of Ice. But this is now TP out time. Observer Ward, rather interesting location. Like, that's obviously rather deceiving how far that ward sees out, but if this tree line gets cleaned off, they'll have perfect vision. But inside the pit, and I'll let him go in. This is the vision from the Radiant side right now. They see absolutely nothing. The orb flies right at the top of Roshan. Scandal! He's going to jump in and try and contest this, but he gets beaten down! Nyx Assassin got the stun. Roshan killed off the Radiant side. Puck takes the Aegis Immortal. Weaver! Actually, no. Weaver got the Aegis Immortal, sorry. The BKBs are up from Illidan. They're on the run trying to chase down Yol. Because probably supposed to be the best ability he could have. That's the spike. Carapace. Goblack jumps in, leaps away. Concoction will kill him off. Scandal's come back in towards this fight. They trigger off the Aegis. He has to phase shift out this one. If he dies again after buyback, it's going to be a horrible, horrible thing for him. But Scandal, back up to full life. That was actually third Roshan, so I assume he got the cheese through this fight. And Jotam shields up, but he'll pop. Three heroes on the sidelines, worth the buyback. Now that's going to pick up Light of Heaven. He is still the critical hero to kill. Either that or they just say screw it and go down for the mid-racks. Light of Heaven will take the tier 2 tower in the top lane as trade-off for it. But Nahaz, can you confirm or deny? Was that the cheese? That's the only explanation I can have that Puck managed to regenerate his life point so fast. Unless Rubik stole the heal and he got the Shadow Word at the same time, but I only saw maybe the heal. Jump in, y'all. Ooh, all the hex. Shikuchi's there. They need to slow him down. They need Light of Heaven dead. Shiva's card. The damage is not enough. Oh, he time-lapses. He was really fearful. And the Shikuchi wouldn't last long enough and that attack would connect. The bugs are coming out. The tower is still not down yet. Face shift from Scandal. That upheaval. Nyx Assassin will get the stun. Pushing BZZ back. Mana burning him down too. And Roskis, they will retreat. Unable to bring down the tower. But we have buybacks from Puck. And Puck, and nothing but Puck. He was the only one to buy back during this engagement. Ah, you're trying to figure out the Warlock question. Ah, oh, the shame. Alright, can't confirm deny. Chat, confirm deny. You guys have faster... You guys have really fast eyes. For some reason, my eyes have been off tonight. Even though I got that kill. One on the bottom, one on the top. What was actually mid? Oh, man. So, okay. Easy kill. Easy kill. Not much worth summoning the Necrogus to try and help him out with this one so they can pursue him. Yeah, it is. Yeah, and there's the Dextra damage. Nyx Assassin takes the Warlock down. And that's Warlock who doesn't have buyback. He's 523 gold short. Yol and Scanlan are going to try and push out this bottom lane as quickly as possible, but with that movement coming from VP, the tier 2 tower in the middle lane for Roskis, days is numbered. In fact, I don't think it's even days, it's basically minutes. Because you've got so much, you still got so much damage coming out of Light of Heaven. 5.8k gold still on him. Sell that hand of Midas and pick up some life, please, Light of Heaven. It could be heart, it could be anything. It could even be more damage. He still needs to have a directed. Monkey King Bar could help him to bring down Seedoy. Because he's still got that evasion signal, but look at the Necrobook units! They're just fighting it up! He BKB's up in Light of Heaven! He's almost dead, he time-lapses! No, he doesn't! He has to buy back, and he time-lapses himself back into the fight! So his BKB will go, and now he's trying to man-fight it! Puck's on the sidelines! Goldblack runs away, Yol stuns himself with the Alchemist stun! Light of Heaven back out again! Seedoy shows his back! Light of Heaven still having trouble, now Warlock drops the ulti! Fatal Bonds still couldn't trigger it! The Spy Carapace holds him out for now! He just has to sit there for so long, but they got him. They got Light of Heaven. They got him twice over. We have it on the boot. This is the danger zone. This is where Roskis can win this game. BZZ's got the gem. He knows 6 assassins behind him. The bottom lane's pushing a long, long way. But Roskis just have to make a beeline for the middle. Seedoy's healing up as he goes, but he doesn't really have a lot of regeneration. Nowhere near that of most Bristlebusters that normally have the heart. But lost with his life going down. No buyback because it was on cooldown. I bet you he wishes now he spent that 5k gold Seedoy. Oh, no. Roskis, they're in more trouble. They just lost their Bristleback before the fight's even begun. Warlock doesn't have his chaotic offering. He's trying to slow him down with the upheaval. There's TB coming back. Bristleback's going to fight again. They've got to bring down Illidan. The Fatal Bonds is connecting them all up right now. Keeping up with the goo. Illidan, one more attack. He goes into the BKB, but he will die. There's only two supporters alive for VP. Roskis, now to bring down the mid racks. Buyback comes from the Alchemist, but no BKB, no Chemical Rage. He's basically an acid spray and a concoction. That's all he's basically got. Seedoy, all the jump from Yol to stop God. CN throws the ulti down, but a jump down by Goblack. He kills the fast up and moves over towards Sergei. Tries to stay alive with the Ghost Scepter, but Goblack now with a double kill. Mid racks, Nyx Assassin buys back. How much more have they got in the tank? The concoction flies to Seedoy. Necro units on his tail. Goblack leeching up Illidan. Illidan, he's going to lose his life. Now there's no buyback for him. 85 seconds on the sideline. Still Light of Heaven. He's about to respawn. Seedoy, he needs more movement speed to get himself away. Meanwhile, Goblack killing off Sergei. He's going to keep him with only two players up. There's a stun. He's still got Shadowblade jump in. One charges. Pounce it down. Who's he going to get this time? Jotam, no ulti. Scandal rejoining the engagement too. Side of the Vice already been used. Shiva's guard once triggered off. He kills off Sergei. Now over towards Jotun. Weaver comes back to life again. And I'm still not quite sure now this is enough for RoX to win. Yeah, they've got to back up. Now Bristleback has to go back to heal. He's walked almost all the way back to base with BTs, so he can return to this fight. And they've got to go again. There's no real choice. Line of Heaven dishes out a lot of damage. He doesn't have his butterfly, he just picks up an Eagle Song instead. But there's still a couple of Necro units on the field, and he knows how much damage he can dish out. Shikuchi into Scandal, hits him once, hits him twice, the Hex is off. Goldblast on the way into. He needs a bash on Line of Heaven. BKB, time lapse now out. Runs up towards the high ground. They have no more disable on Line of Heaven, but now Line of Heaven has no longer is BKB. Tier 3 tower goes on the Radiant's bottom lane. Still no Rack's favor going the way of RoX, but that's about to change. With Seedoy cracking out the bottom Radiant's racks. Bottom melee first, range to follow. Rotation middle lane. Line of Heaven trying to push this lane back out again. He does it. No, he has no evasion. He has no direct hit as well into Seedoy. The Necro units are up. So are a lot of the rest of VP, but they got Line of Heaven. He's toast. They will push for the GG call here. There's only gate number one of three, however, there's a lot more coming up. But they're not going to give it up just yet. The upheaval's making it hard for anyone to come in close. The Hex over on Seedoy. Arsar dropping down the ult. It's a lot of damage going the way of the Bristleback. But then, at the same time, Bristleback can tank all of that up. And it's Goldblack with a mega kill streak. He has gone 14-4 in this matchup. Seedoy, 11-3-14 coming up for the Bristleback. Nyx initiates Goldblack. Stun won't hit. Lincoln Spear is able to hold it off, and he gets a bash on Sergei too. Double kill for Goldblack again. Now going for Jotun. He's got another pounce in a second. Illidan's already starting to prep the stun. Throws over towards Seedoy. Puck can jump back out of this and join the fight again. Shiva's guard over to Illidan. Slowing him down. And Goldblack comes in for another kill. And it's going to be Puck this time around. Jotun, the last player left alive for VirtusPro. Battling it out. His ulti protects him for now, but not anymore. GG. GG in favor of RoX. And that is going to be the throne to go with it.
Radiance Ancient is under attack. Dire victory.
So down she goes. Down she goes. And first game goes to RoX. This, as I said, though, is a best of three, so we're going to have ourselves a short break and come back for our second match in the grand final for the EIZO Cup. €1,250 up for grabs for first prize. Second place gets a guaranteed €500. So money for all. Money for all, courtesy of EIZO. Make sure as well you head yourself over to joinDOTA.com and sign up. If you have not done so already, it's over in the news section. If you haven't managed to find it, it's very, very easy to find over on joinDOTA.com. That's the place to go to. And look for the article that says EIZO Cup game giveaway. And then just answer the question. In fact, here it is on your screen right now. Just this article right here. Just below the misery article about him staying in Europe. So yeah, head yourself over there, sign yourself up, and we'll see you back here in a couple of moments' time for game number two of your grand final.